Hello everyone and welcome. I'm Billy and today I'm going to lead you step by step through creating a succulent centerpiece for your garden or inside your home. So first let's start with a couple of things that we're going to need. A pair of scissors, a few different types of rocks. I have some big river rocks like this. And then I also have some tiny, more decorative stones. A nice pot to plant it in, some dirt. A bunch of succulents. I like to get these bigger ones here and I'm gonna show you how to break them up. A couple of other things that you'll need to add a nice creative touch, a focal point, some filler. Let's get started. When I pour my dirt into the pot, I don't wanna be packing it in too tightly because I wanna leave a lot of room for it to settle in the pot. With this succulent, I'm gonna open it up over the dirt right here. So that way, if there's any spillage, it's kind of just going right into the pot and I'm not wasting anything. But now that I have all of these big, huge roots that are down here on the bottom, I don't necessarily need those inside this pot. So all of this can pretty much get pruned off. So that way it has a lot of extra room in the pot and it's not already overgrown. Pruning these off aren't gonna injure the succulent at all, but we wanna be delicate about the way that we're doing it. We don't wanna just be ripping it. I'll use some scissors to just prune them off the bottom. As you can see, I took off a considerable amount of dirt and this will be plenty for it to really take off inside this pot. Because I have the dirt all the way up at the top of this pot, I'm gonna kind of wanna angle this outward just a little bit like this. So that way when I have all of the other plants tucked in nicely around it, it'll sort of be spilling out of the pot and give it that nice, really full effect that I like. So just by using my hand, I'm gonna scoop away a little bit of this dirt and I'm gonna plop this little aloe right in here and then scoop that other dirt around. I want it to be right up nice and tight up against the edge of this pot. So right here isn't one of the best to break up because it needs more time to mature. But once it has other little buds that start popping off of this aloe, there'll be plenty to break off from. So you'll see more of how I break up the succulents from some of the other plants instead of this one in particular. I think some of this might look nice to spill out. This one also is a really nice contrasting color as well. I love to try to mix the colors as much as I can inside the pot so you're not seeing too much of the same shades in one concentrated area. Now, as you can see, as I started taking some of the dirt off, this succulent sort of naturally just starts breaking apart. I'm actually gonna just take this piece and just set it over here aside, and I'll come back to it later, maybe even so I can have a piece of it wind up in my second planter. Now that I have a few little pieces broken off from this plant, I'm gonna tuck it in nice and close to the aloe that's already in the plant. If you're doing this and following along with me, you don't have to have the same succulents or the same plants or even do it in the same order that I'm doing it. It should really be your creative process and place everything where you want it to go. And you should have some sort of a vision for what your plant will look like in the end. I see mine having a cute little path with a variation of some of the stones. And so I don't wanna fill up the entire area with the plants. I wanna leave a little bit of room inside this planter to allow for that. So if that's something that you wanna do as well, keep that in mind for as you're placing your succulents in. If I have questions about plants, I have this amazing app that I use and it's called Plant Snap. And anytime I'm just hiking through the woods and I'm like, wow, what the hell is that plant? I'll take a picture of it. And then the app has an identifying feature that will tell you exactly what the plant is, what its region of origin is, and what type of care that it needs. And it's like a little encyclopedia for all things plants. But I'm just breaking apart this succulent here. It's pretty much the same process for each one of these plants. This one has a really nice spilling effect, so I'm gonna put that right over here next to this other one because I like it when it's overflowing from the pot. And because this is going to be the focal point that I have chosen, I'm gonna put that in there now because this is gonna take up much more room than some of the other succulents that I'm adding. This shrub is not a succulent. It is called purple salvia. I'm gonna be planting this in what will be the back of my planter. And just like the succulents, I'm gonna tuck it in pretty close to the edge of the pot, but differently. I'm not gonna have it angled and spilling out like I did for the succulents. This one I'm gonna have standing straight up. So take a look at it now that I've added this in. We call it the focal point, obviously, because it's what our eye is gonna go to first. But in this little path that I'm envisioning kind of angling around the focal point, it's gonna just look like a normal sized tree in the little seam that I'm making here. Little special touch that I love adding into these arrangements is like that one little knick-knack item that you have around your home that you cannot find the perfect place for it to go. Stick it in your little planter and it just adds a little ornament and a little decorative piece, and it's sometimes like the perfect home that you were looking for that one oddball item. So I just used that extra dirt that I had pushed back from going around the shrub, and I'm using it to elevate the dirt over here a little bit up above the rim of the pot. And the rocks and things that I'm gonna use is gonna keep the dirt from spilling out as I water it, because it'll really weigh it down and have that protective layer for the dirt. My dirt's a little bit full in there, so I'm gonna use this extra dirt now over my second pot, so that way I might be able to conserve some of the soil that I purchased. Great. So since this one is so big, check this out. I'm just gonna kind of pull it apart like this, and I'll take this smaller piece and I'll set that aside to go into the pot, but I'm gonna do it one more time. Each of these little bunches has one little core place in the bottom where it's going through the dirt. So I'm gonna consider that to be one full plant. So I'm gonna pull that whole piece and not be ripping in the middle of where that main root is going into the dirt. Pieces that had fallen off, if I just lay it on the top of my dirt like that, it will start to grow roots down into the dirt and create a whole new plant. So I love that about succulents. As far as the succulents, I'll tuck them right up against one another. I found that when they're sort of grouped together, it keeps the soil cooler and more protected from the direct sun, so they grow much better than when they're bone dry. So I really do tuck them right in with one another. Any of these succulents that are top heavy, at the end I'm going to use these bigger rocks, and then I'll place them down on top of the base of the plants that are more top heavy, so that way it secures it more down into the planter themselves. As you add the plants, your little vision might change. Like for instance, originally I had an arc, but now I'm starting to have a little bit more of a windy trail, and I'm just allowing that to happen organically as I add in additional shapes. This is one of my favorite touches, is adding this kind of filler into the planters. All right, so I'm just kind of digging my fingers right underneath right here and grabbing a good chunk of it with my hands. And then I'm just gonna gently tear, and it will just pull apart. And this is gonna come under here and become part of my hill. And keeping it up nice and high, I'm walking around my whole planter and looking at it from every single side. So that way, when I rotate it to get new sun or, sit in a different area of the yard, it looks good on every angle that I'm looking at it. So even though I've referred to a certain area in the back before, it will still look good even if it's in the front. I'm gonna start adding some rocks in now. I'm gonna just start taking little handfuls of the rocks and just guiding them to fall into this little path. Eventually, this little setting that I've created is gonna become completely overgrown and you're not gonna be able to see the little path or see the little hill anymore, and it's all gonna have to get turned over. But when you turn it over, that's when you're breaking up apart all these little pieces and really spreading the life out there. So now I've got my bigger river rocks and I'm gonna start weighing down some of these top heavy plants. So this one here is pretty much done. So I'm gonna move on to the second one, which I'm gonna try to make a completely different creation than this first one. It will be repeating the same process, but I'll move a little bit faster through this one because I already have a lot of these plants broken up from the first planter. Time putting together your succulent arrangement. I would love to see the creations that you've come up with. So tag me in the comments below and share your succulent arrangement photos with me. To care for these guys now, I recommend that you water them a few times a week, or you can hit them every day with a spray bottle and keep them nice and misted. Thanks for joining me. See ya. Bye.